Blackstone Publishing presents His Burial Too, The Calleshire Chronicles by Catherine Aird. This book is read by Derek Perkins. For Jennifer, Peter, Jonty, and Elizabeth, with love. Who has his birthday has his burial too. As we into the world come, out we go. Epitaph in Crondale Church. The chapter headings are taken from the plays of John Webster and Cyril Tourneur. Men oft are valued high when they're most wretched. 1. It was the knocking which woke Fenella Tindall. Not the first time it happened. The first time the knocking came, she was dreaming so deeply that she didn't even hear it. In her dream, she wasn't tucked up safely at home in her own bedroom in the English village of Cleete at all. She was miles and miles away. In her dream, she was in Italy, in Rome, to be exact, walking down the Via Veneto with the two young Trelanti children. It was in her dream, as it had always been in real life, the pudgy little Nicola hurrying along beside her, her chubby hand tightly clutched in Fenella's, and the older and more adventuresome Giovanni skipping ahead of them both. Nevertheless, the knocking must have begun to register on her mind, because her dream changed gear slightly. She was calling to Giovanni now, telling him not to go too far ahead on his own. She had spent a lot of time in Italy with the Trelanti children doing just that. She doubted whether in the long run anyone at all, was going to be able to keep Giovanni back. Already the boy was slim-hipped and handsome, and as lithe as quicksilver. And someday, too, not so many light years away, his sister Nicola, dark, slow, and almost insultingly good-looking, was going to break a heart or two. Not that that was Fenella's problem. Her problem had been teaching them English. Fenella's own Italian was good. That had been how she had got the job in the first place. But she always spoke to the children in English. That was what their mother, the Principessa, wanted. That was how the English Miss Fenella Tindall of Cleete had come to be in Italy at all, to teach English to the Trelanti children. So that it is their second tongue, Miss Tindall, their mother had said firmly. That is what I want. And even that wasn't Fenella Tindall's problem anymore. Not now. Not since she had had to come back to England again. The knocking came again, and this time it did reach her bedroom. The Italian dream faded. Her sleep-soaked mind forgot the Principessa and, in the infinitely accommodating way of dreams, tossed up an association to match the extraneous noise. She was hammering away at something now, she wasn't quite sure what. But urgently. Now another figure appeared at the edge of her dream. A man, this time. She couldn't see him very clearly, but again, in the way of dreams, she somehow knew who he was. Giuseppe Mardoni. She was aware of him there, small, dark, and engaging, and on the fringe. There was another bout of knocking, and she came one stage nearer true wakefulness. Another thought flitted through her mind. Wake Duncan with thy knocking. Then the sound, the real sound, came again, and all the layers of unconsciousness were stripped away. She opened her eyes, admitted the world, and was properly awake at last. The Trelanti children, Macbeth, and the insubstantial Giuseppe, were all thoroughly banished by the present. The present apparently consisted of someone knocking at the front door. Fenella struggled out of bed and snatched at her dressing gown. It was a beautiful dressing gown, one which she had brought back with her from Rome and really cherished. She stopped suddenly. As she had been feeling about for her bedroom slippers, her eye had fallen on her little bedside clock. It said 8:30. She blinked. It couldn't be as late as 8:30. Not 8:30 in the morning. What about breakfast? What about her father getting off to work in Beerbury? She shook herself. This wouldn't do at all. After all, the whole idea had been that something like this shouldn't happen. This was what she had come home from Italy for, to look after her father. She didn't seem to be making a very good job of it this morning. She opened her bedroom door and shot along the upstairs landing. She called out to her father as she hurried downstairs to answer the door. Even in her present rush, she was vaguely surprised.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.